Morocco now, the greatest comedy stand-up team, Jerry Lewis. Take them. Forget it.
Roll it.
Take Roland and Martin. Forget them.
Already, here we go, as planned. Lord Alfred, get ready for this. Yucks for bucks, if you will. Live from the TNT studios, it's America's newest comedy team, soon to be seen in Las Vegas. Los Angeles at the Comedy Store, Zeke's Bar and Grill in Jersey City. Would you please welcome for the debut here on TNT of this comedy team, Mr. Fuji and the magnificent Morocco, right here.
Thank you. It's great to hear, be here tonight. I just flew in from Coast. Boy, what a trip around here.
How hot was it?
I'll tell you, it was hotter than Joan Collins on her wedding night. It got so bad that some of the Hollywood stars were getting together to raise money for air conditioning, needing to call their concert Kool-Aid, which reminds me of the time I raised money to help a musical group and called it Band-Aid. Eat your heart out, Bob Hope. Actually, I just got back from playing Las Vegas.
You play Las Vegas?
I'll tell you, I walked through so many casinos and clubs, I almost developed club foot. I put more money in the slot machines than Liberace spends on suits. And the showgirls, wow, are they ever beautiful.
How beautiful are they?
They're so beautiful. They make Bo Derek look like Rambo. And they're built better than a Rolls Royce. I tell you, they're so well endowed, they could get part-time jobs as life rafts on ocean liners. I kept thinking of that old TV show, Leave It to Cleavage. You won't find better looking buns in a bakery. Of course, they were all over like pigeons on a statue.
Did you get out and enjoy the great Nevada air?
Sure I did. I played golf with an old midget wrestling pal of mine. Of course, we had to play miniature golf. Boy, was he short.
How short was he?
I'll tell you, he was so small, he needed a camel across the sand trap. He was waiting for Moses to part the water hazard, and when I yelled, for he thought I was making fun. What are you doing? Come on.
Now, what is the guy laughing about?
I'm rolling now. Seriously, folks. Listen, let me tell you about some of the brilliant wrestlers I've got to face in the ring now.
How brilliant are they?
Take Hulk Hogan, for instance. He's built like Pillsbury Doughboy. And when he points his finger in the air, when he's in the ring, he's not telling everyone he's number one. He's just bragging about how high he can count. And Junkyard Dog, you like that one, huh? Junkyard Dog, he's looking like a lip-sword alligator.
Oh.
And he thinks he can dance. I've seen better moves in a rest home for retired lawn ornaments. Then there's Paul Orndorff. He's so vain, he has mirrors in his refrigerator. He's got about as much to be vain about as Gene Okerlund has hair. Hey, Gene, old buddy, I see more growth in the cue ball. Gene's afraid to get in the bowling alley. Where he lost your hat. That's okay. He's always trying to stick his fingers into his head and roll it down the lane. Oh, boy, David Letterman, here I come.
How about some tropical stuff?
Tropical.
I don't care. Mine don't feel too good lately.
You want some topical stuff? I'll cool down over here, will you?
Might want to try topical, but that's okay.
I'll give you topical. Spies have really been in the news lately. We send Russian secrets, they send us a fallout. It works out, Canada sends us bacon, we send them acid rain. And how about that Hands Across America celebration? Yeah. I tell you, I haven't seen so many strangers touching one another since Hugh Hefner's last birthday party at the Playboy Mansion. I'm telling you, this comedy stuff is easy. Now for the big finish.
How big is it?
Sure. How big is it? Trust me, Fuji. Ferdinand Marcos, Ronald Reagan, and Mikhail Gorbachev are in the airplane. That's about to crash. But there's only one parachute. Reagan says he should get the chute because he's a senior member. Gorbachev claims he should get the chute because he's the leader of a big, strong nation. And Marcos says that in the spirit of democracy, they should take a vote. Marcos won by a landslide, 94-2. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
What is this?
The hook came about 3 minutes late, I think.
Well, this has sure been a bright spot for me the last 2 weeks. I enjoyed that.
You did, huh?
Yes, I did. You notice the delivery, how it flowed. They didn't step on each other's lines. They were just great. Just great. You get the one about the gorilla and the banana?
You're sick.
Yes,
I
am
sick.
Sick
person. Mentally, I'm talking about. Well, if you think that was good. You thought that was funny.
That's great.
Obvious to me that neither one of them can read.
Read?
Yeah.
They did that off the top of their head. They didn't read nothing.
Off the top of their head.
Right.
You are a sick person. You really
You like the one about the gorilla and the bananas?
Need help. Yeah. Gorillas like bananas, peanuts, all kinds of things.
Gorillas like neck braces?
Yeah, well, as long as they're on somebody else. Still.